This is a movie about a review about this Onkyo power stereo amplifier, the M504, and the Onkyo Integra stereo preamplifier, the P304, the perfect match. And this set is a old set. I think it is from 1980-1985, not sure, but it is an old set. And like I told you before, this is how the preamp is looking from the inside. It is just unbelievable how these guys make this thing. And the sound quality you will hear later, the sound quality is just perfect. It is, you know, if you can find a set like this, yes, and I'm not sure why I'm selling it. Well, I'm selling it because it doesn't fit in that cabinet, and I need the money to sell this thing to buy my camera. Yes, I explained that in my other movie. I need that money. I need that camera very hard because it's not nice. As you can see, my other cam over here, I record the sound with that cam, and I use this cam for the imaging because both of them have their weaknesses. The weaknesses of the cam I have in my hand is the sound, and the weakness of that cam is the imaging. So, and I hope the cam I'm going to buy have no weaknesses in the sound, and I know the imaging is good. But strange enough, all these reviews on the internet, on YouTube, you know, all these top reviewers, they never talk about sound. Yes, and sound is one of the most important things from a camera, because well, if your microphones from your camera are good, you don't need an external microphone. Yes, and they always talk about having that external microphone connection or not. Yes, you don't need an external microphone connection if those microphones are good, but they never give an answer. None of those top reviewers give an answer. So well, I hope it is good. Anyway, it have a microphone in connection, so if it doesn't have good microphones, I can always use one of my external microphones. These are perfect microphones, and to use that when I use it to record these movies. And this is a very important movie, because this thing, yes, believe me, I thought I reviewed Onkyo earlier, and I was not overwhelmed by the sound. I was not overwhelmed by the sound at all. Yes, and I thought, well, Onkyo, you know, what's Onkyo? Yes, I love Mayakai. I love Sansu sound. Yes, I have to pick up that Accuphase later in the evening. Yes, not sure how that thing sounds, but believe me, guys, believe me. Not only is this Onkyo one of the most beautiful amplifiers there is on the market, yes, it is even one of the best sounding amps I ever heard. It even beats my Akai. It beats, for the first time, it beats, something beats my Akai, yes. And it beats my Akai because I missed that harshy sound from my tweeters that Akai gives, and this thing just sound like it have to sound, you know. And it have a tremendous power, 165 watt a channel. And then you can say, well, you don't need that power. That's true, you don't need that power. And probably, I'm not sure about that, you will also have a higher electricity bill, but I'm not sure about that, you know, because it isn't A-class, it is not an A-class device, so I'm not sure how much more, because it is a heavy travo inside, a very heavy two travos inside, 8 end filters, yes. Let me see if I can, well, it's impossible to show you, but yeah. You can see on the pictures on the internet that this thing have two very big travos, yes, and 8 end filters, so 4 end filters each, same like my Sansui G901DB. It also have 8 end filters, and that one only have one travo. And well, you can find, I saw prices on the internet that sometimes they ask a lot of money, but these are dealers, but you can find these The, a setup like this, the preamp and the main amp, you can find for 500 to 600 euro, I think, or maybe even for 400 if you are lucky. Last year I went to Utrecht, yes, for the same set. I could buy this same set for 350 euro, the preamp and the main amp, but the thing was ugly, bulbs were out, and very ugly. And I didn't bought it. I didn't bought it because I thought, no, I don't like the looks of this thing, and I left it where it was and I returned home. But this thing isn't perfect. It has its spots, as you can see. I just put a black permanent marker on it, and so it is a little bit repaired. But the front plate is beautiful, no scratches on the front plate, and that's what I like. Also no scratches on the front plate from the preamplifier, so that is okay. It has an incredible weight from over 23 kilo, only the main amplifier, an incredible weight that is. Because the thing is just, well, 2 times 160 watt, 65 watt, 2 big travos. I think it have to weigh that heavy. Yes, it is high, as you can see. Yeah, it also have some damage over here, but yeah, you can make that nice with a permanent marker. It is gone in 1 minute, so it's not a big deal. The thing from this Onkyos is that these are the original bulbs. Yes, but nowadays you can find those LED light bulbs. They cost you 25 euro, and then you have a complete set for 25 euro. I think there are 4 LED light bulbs, and then you have a much better looking lightning in these VU meters. Yes, I also saw on YouTube, yes, you have to go on YouTube, that there is a guy who made a system that you can change the lightning inside with a remote control, and you can dim or make the LED lights burning harder or making them burn softer with a dimmer. Yes, and you can change that color between this original green, yes, blue, red, I'm not sure other colors, but a beautiful system. And I was overwhelmed when I saw this movie, and I think I'm not sure if your local repair guy can do that for you, but if you have a Onkyo Integra 504 and this system don't, well, I know that this system, that remote control, cost only 5 euro on eBay, so it's not the investment. You only need a guy who can do it for you, who can implant that thing into that amplifier, and you don't have to worry that the bulbs will broke. Yes, these LED bulbs will last forever. Yeah, they will survive you. So you do it only one time, and after that, well, the thing is beautiful, 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 beautiful lightning. What I saw on YouTube, and this is how it sounds. This is how it sounds. I will give you a sound example, and really, when I say that this thing sounds beautiful, then I mean beautiful, 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 beautiful. And let me see, this is how it sounds. Let me find some. Well, let me start.
You give your hand to me, and then you say hello. And I can hardly speak, but you walk away beside the lucky guy.
These are flex songs, yes, that's why I'm spinning them. They are flex songs.
I can't wait a moment. Let me show you the way.
this is a cha-cha-cha. I don't know if you know dancing, but if you know the salsa, this is the same moves you make with salsa, but this is the cha-cha-cha. That is 1-1-2, 1-1-2, and I love dancing that style. Cha-cha-cha.
Robert Gray. Anyway, my battery is almost finished, so I have to end this movie. And really, this thing, I mean, if you're gonna buy, there is a new Onkyo Integra. The thing is only 70 watt a channel. The thing is beautiful looking. Even more, it is a silver shiny chrome metal, you know. It is more beautiful as this thing, I believe. But this thing is the better one. This thing, I mean, that thing costs you 2,500 euro in the shops. 2 × 70 watt. Yes, if you buy a thing like this, you have 2 × 165 watt. You bring it to a guy who know what he does, and it will cost you maybe, if you do both the main amp and the preamp, yes, it will cost you maybe 350-400 euro maximum, and then you have two brand new sounding units. Yes, this thing is not used that much, so it doesn't use a renovation. Yes, but if you need that renovation and it will cost you 400, you buy the complete set for about 600 euro, maybe 700, even 800, then you are finished with only 1200 euro. And with the 1200 euro, it will cost, that's the half what you have to pay for a new Onkyo, that new Onkyo receiver in the shop. Yes, and that one only gives you 70 watt, and 70 watt, guys, believe me, you miss that power, really, because you don't need that 2,165 watt. I admit that, but you heard that back in your sound. You heard that this thing have that reserve power. And because people always think, well, why you need 165 watt? Why you need 120 watt a channel if you only spin not even 3 watt in your living room? You heard that power, believe me. You heard that power, that reserve power. And that's nice from this thing. This thing has plenty reserve. It's a beautiful device. And, well, it just sounds awful. It just sounds fantastic. And I'm not sure if the new Onkyo Integra have the same sound. Well, I don't believe. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you like this video, put your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe on my channel. And for now, I say bye-bye.